So let's go to part two of the webinar. What are the Medicare enrollment steps for individuals who are under the age of 65? An individual who is getting Social Security Disability Insurance or railroad benefits will be contacted a few months before he or she becomes eligible for Medicare to let them know what to expect. Then he or she would be automatically enrolled in both Medicare Parts A and B, but each person has the option of turning down Part B since he or she must pay a premium in order to get Part B, unless, of course, there is some cost-sharing assistance, which we'll discuss in a little while. So Medicare enrollment for individuals who are under age 65. Who may enroll in Medicare? Much of this is a review of what we've just covered. Either an individual who is getting Social Security Disability Insurance and railroad benefit or railroad benefits and has satisfied the waiting period. A disabled widow or widower between ages 50 and 65 who had not applied for Social Security Disability Insurance because he or she is already getting another kind of Social Security benefit. This is rare, but it could be retirement, survivors, or another benefit. Some government employees who are disabled before age 65, remember those who pay into Medicare but do not pay into Social Security. An insured individual, a spouse or a dependent child with end-stage renal disease. An individual who had Medicare Part B in the past but had previously dropped the coverage. Or an individual who had affirmatively turned down Part B when he or she became eligible for Part A. So let's focus on Medicare enrollment for those who initially affirmatively declined Part B. The enrollment timeframes must be reviewed carefully, as failure to enroll timely may result in a Part B late enrollment penalty. And that penalty is 10% for every 12 months that the person is not enrolled. Timely enrollment periods include an initial enrollment period, which is the 7-month period surrounding the notice of the disability, or a special enrollment period up to 8 months following separation from coverage. This is based on current employment. The general enrollment period is January 1 to March 31st, coverage that begins next July. But remember, again, if a person elects under the general enrollment period, there may be penalties involved. If there is a late penalty incurred under age 65, however, it will be vacated when the person turns 65 and the individual receives a new initial enrollment period along with everyone else who becomes eligible for Medicare at 65.